Hey guys, I'm Gabriella and welcome to a scary text message story. Today we're gonna be playing Seven Strangers. Seven Strangers, 14 Eyes, One Mission. This sounds so good. Let's jump right in and see what's gonna happen. Unknown number one. Wake up, Lee, you're in danger. Who is this? A friend of a friend. What's the problem? I'm going to tell you something. Try not to be afraid. And whatever you do, don't look.
Don't look where?
Under your bed. There's a man hiding there.
How is that not supposed to freak me out?
He's waiting for your parents to go to work.
What? I'm waking my dad up.
No, trust me. You don't want your parents involved. The man is only interested in you.
What should I do?
Get dressed, but do it slowly. Act like nothing's wrong. Then go downstairs, put on your big blue hat, and leave the house through the back door.
How do I know I can trust this person? What if they're in on it with each other? What's happening?
At this moment in time, I don't want to scare you.
It's too late for that!
Are you downstairs yet? I'm putting my shoes on in the kitchen. Tell me when you're outside.
Only if you tell me who you are.
There's no time. And you wouldn't believe me even if I did.
I'm not going anywhere until you do.
Promise me you'll leave the house if I tell you.
I promise. Don't promise anything, Lee. It's a stranger texting you, telling you to leave your house. No.
Who is it?
What?
I'm you.
Okay, I'm outside. Wow, Lee, you took that extraordinarily well.
I want you to climb over the fence in the backyard.
Are you crazy? That's Mrs. Mangle's garden.
If you want to get through this, you have to do exactly what I say. There are people who want to hurt you.
Why are you helping me?
I'm not. I'm helping myself.
Who are these people? Again, Lee just was like, oh, you're me from the future? Okay, cool. What should we do next?
They're like me. Abominations of nature. Sent from the future. You expect me to believe this? Trust me, you'll believe in it about 30 years.
No chance!
Ha, I didn't realize how annoying I was. Now climb the fence and make your way to 13th Street and keep your head down. I didn't come alone. There are six other people looking for you. I need to get you somewhere safe. There's an old abandoned house on Lincoln Lane.
It'll take me hours to walk there.
So catch a bus. The quickest route is the 138 on Boulder Avenue, I think. But they could be watching the stops.
I can see a taxi.
Perfect.
I've only got 10 bucks.
That should be enough. Get in it. The address is 1381 Lincoln Lane.
Wait, my phone is ringing. It's another unknown number.
Is it you?
Don't answer it!
Wait, so are all the people back in time different versions of myself? Like, what is happening?
But it could be important!
Get in the taxi right now!
Lee Lawson?
Yes?
Step away from the taxi! I can't do this! This is too much back and forth!
You guys, if you're enjoying this as much as I am, make sure to subscribe because I post awesome videos like this all throughout the week.
Are you serious?
I've just been told to get in it!
Who are you?
A friend of a friend.
Not another one. Do you want to save me too?
Of course.
Who from?
Yourself.
So you're an older version of me too?
Do you know what's happening?
Not really.
Complicated, isn't it?
I'm usually good at solving problems.
I know. You grow up to be a genius.
Where are you?
I'm across the street. In the white car.
This is so confusing.
I'll explain everything if you come with me.
Do not get into the stranger's car! Oh my god!
I'm not going anywhere near you! Before you make that decision, take a quick look at the taxi driver, but don't make it too obvious. Do you recognize him?
He looks familiar.
Trust me, Lee, do not get in that vehicle!
Is it like another older version of me?
I won't! I'm going to the police instead! They won't be able to protect you from the others.
What others? What is going on?
Seven people are hunting you. Six will cause you harm, but if you come into my car, I will save you.
How am I supposed to believe that?
Lee? Oh, great. It's the third one. Let me guess. Don't get in the car.
Don't listen to anyone but me.
Are you kidding me? Another unknown number? Send me a picture so I can see exactly who I'm talking to. I'm afraid I can't do that. Goodbye, unknown number three.
Okay. Wow, great selfie, unknown number three. That's cheating. I suppose it won't hurt. There!
What the heck? You look just like the taxi driver I've just walked away from.
And he looks like somebody else I know. We should look familiar. We are all you in 30 years' time. None of this makes any sense. Seriously, comment down below what you would do if your future self texted you. There are 7 of us, and we all want the same thing. You!
Why? What have I done?
We need your DNA, a younger version of our own blood. Do you know what a clone is? A genetically identical copy of something? Close enough. You're a very important scientist in the future.
I knew it!
I told Mason I'd be smarter and more famous than him. You make 7 exact copies of yourself, but the clones have a limited shelf life. What does that mean? It means we only live for a few years, but in the future, for a lucky few, there are ways of visiting the past. Your future self needs your younger, fresher DNA samples. We came back to get one of your bones.
What am I, bones?
And a few liters of your blood. The clone who succeeds gets to live forever.
Why only one of you?
Let's just say the future has limited resources. You can blame your friend Mason Brady for that.
Wait, wasn't Mason Brady the one who became like the evil like nanoscientist in the future when the future granddaughter contacted her? You haven't seen that? Click the playlist up there. You'll know what I'm talking about.
So what do you say, Lee? Will you help me?
Will I help you by giving you one of my bones and a liter of blood? No! Figure it out yourself in the future.
Please. I'm sorry. I won't be helping any of you. But I am going to sort this mess out. You can't get away. We have your memories. We know your routine. We are you. Only older and wiser. So make it easier on yourself, Lee. Choose which version of yourself gets to live and which 6 die. Hey, where is he? I'm following him. He just arrived at his school, but it's Saturday. It's football training, guys, but you don't play for the team. Not in your future, no. But the best thing about the future is that we can change it by what we do in the present.
What are you doing?
I just spoke to Coach Manford. He's always wanted me and my friend Mason Brady to sign up for the team, but we love science so much.
Why science guys so much? All of his focus from being a scientist to being a football player?
Turns out I had a change of heart. I signed up.
Why would you do that? You're a scientific genius!
That may be so, but I've always been torn between science and sport, and you guys helped me make a decision today. If I'm really as good as football as Coach says I am, you guys won't ever exist in the first place.
What have you done? Okay, I mean, like, that's kind of smart, though, and, like, very self-aware, because if he realizes that by following the scientific path, he ends up creating, like, this huge problem in the future to just turn away from it now, he's a thinker.
What have you done? You stupid boy. Something's gone wrong. I can't feel my fingers.
What the heck? I'm disappearing.
You've ruined everything.
Mason.
So how's football training?
I love it. Are you sure I can't tempt you to play?
You'd make a great wide receiver.
No chance.
Mary bought me a book on nanotechnology and I'm hooked.
We all know how that went, and if you do not, as I said, click up there.
Don't forget the biology chest on Monday. It's okay, I'm still studying, but I prefer to be a star quarterback.
I always thought you wanted to be a star scientist.
I did. I just don't think I'm cut out for it. I've got a feeling it'll be safer for me on the sports field. I'm sure you had a good reason to change your mind.
He's like, try 7. I actually had 7 good reasons. Oh my gosh, that was so much fun!
If you guys enjoyed it as much as I did, make sure to give this video a big thumbs up and subscribe so you don't miss a single video. You can also share this video with one of your friends to get them spooked out as well. Also follow me on Instagram so that way we can hang out in between uploads and check out the awesome videos I have for you guys after this. See you later. Bye!